Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So we are going to start with the numericals related to consolidation of soils. And the first question says that the time for a clay layer to achieve 85% consolidation is 10 years. For U equals to 85%, let us say T1 equals to 10 years. If the layer was half as thick, let us denote the thickness of this layer as D1. And the permeability of this layer as K1 and the compressibility of this layer as MV1. Now it is a ratio based question, that is why I am taking all these in terms of 1 and 2. If the layer was half as thick, if the second layer was D2 and it is D1 by 2 and the permeability is 10 times, so K2 is 10 times K1 and 4 times more compressible. Compressibility is MV2 equals to 4 times MV1. This is the compressibility actually. Then what would be the time required to achieve the same degree of consolidation? We need to calculate what is T2 in this particular question. So we know the formula for TV. Since the consolidation, degree of consolidation is 85% in both the cases, the time factor for 85% will be same in both the cases. TV equals to CV T upon D square. This is the formula that we should use. But CV, since CV is also same in this case, but CV, what is CV? You know, K equals to CV MV gamma W. So CV is actually equal to K upon MV and gamma W. So we will replace CV with this term, since we do not have the data for CV for both the cases, but we have the data for K and MV. Since gamma W is always constant, the unit weight of water will not change. We have K and MV in this question given, so we will write CV in terms of K and MV. We will not write even gamma W, since gamma W is constant. So we can write it as KT upon MV D square. Now this is equal to constant, since it is equal to TV. So we can write as K1 T1 divided by MV1 D1 square equals to K2 T2 divided by MV2 D2 square. So now we just need to replace all these equations, all these variables, K1, and what is T1? T1 is 10 years. What is MV1? MV1 is MV1 and D1 square is D1 square. What is K2? K2 equals to 10 times K1. What is T2? T2 we need to find. What is MV2? MV2 is 4 times MV1. And what is D2 square? D2 square will be equal to D1 square divided by 4. Now this 4 will cancel out with this 4. This MV1 D1 square, MV1 D1 square. And K1 will cancel out with K1. 10 will cancel out with 10. So we will get T2 as 1 year. So this is the value of T2. So if all these values are replaced with these values, then the time for all this consolidation, that means 85% consolidation, will be equal to 1 year only instead of 10 years. So why will we go for this? So the option number is A. This is the correct option. Now moving on to the next question. The next question is again a kind of ratio based question, we can say it, but it is more of a intelligent question. The question is was asked in 2011 and it was of 2 marks. Identical surcharges are placed at the ground surface at sites X and Y. Let me not read out the complete question. I will explain you what the question is actually wanting to say. So there are 2 sites. One site is X site and one is Y site. In this, the soil has a depth of 10 meters. This is a 10 meter depth soil and a surcharge is placed here. This is 10 meter completely and this is a bedrock. That means this is an impermeable stratum. That means the depth will be completely as 10 meter here, since this is a one side consolidation. One way consolidation will take place. So the depth available for consolidation will be equal to 10 meters. And then there is a second case in which in this similar soil, we placed a permeable sand layer in between in the similar fashion. That means nothing has changed, just a sand layer is introduced in between this layer. So now it is 5 meters and 5 meters. Now what you have to determine, what would be the corresponding time for completion of primary consolidation at Y. You are given that consolidation at X takes time T1 equal to 36 months. You have to determine, this is months, not minutes, what will be the time T2 in this situation. So the degree of consolidation will remain the same. Primary consolidation will have to complete. That means the complete consolidation will have to take place. 100% will be the degree of consolidation. But still it is not given. We will not assume that the consolidation degree is 100%. Let us assume it is 70% or 80% or 90%, whatever it is. But TV for both the cases will be same, since consolidation degree should be equal to compare two phenomena. So TV equal to CVT divided by D square. Now see, CV will also be same for both the cases, because since conditions are almost equal. So TV divided by CV will be equal to T divided by D square, and it is equals to a constant C. Now what is T1 divided by D1 square will be equal to T2 divided by D2 square. We just have two cases. What is T1? T1 is 36. What is D1? D1 is 10. So it will be 100. What is T2? T2 needs to be calculated. What is D1? See now, this has two things. Consolidation will take place in both, in two particular situations, in two manners. First, this will also consolidate, and correspondingly this will consolidate. It may happen that one layer consolidates faster than the other layer. Suppose this layer takes 2 months to consolidate. This takes 3 months to consolidate. Then what will we say? We will say that this complete setup gets consolidated in 3 months, not in 2 months. After 2 months, the consolidation of this particular 5 meter layer below this permeable membrane has consolidated. But yet, this layer has not consolidated. So we cannot say that the complete sand has consolidated. Complete soil has yet not consolidated. So the time will be maximum of this and this. This has one D1, this has another type of D1. The depth is different in this, and the depth is different in this. This is the two-way consolidation takes place in the upper layer, but only one-way consolidation takes place in the downward layer. So we will have to calculate the time for both these layers and calculate that what is the maximum of these two times. Then that maximum time will be the time in which the complete soil will consolidate. So how will you calculate that? What is D1 square? See, the depth for this upper layer is 2.5 meter DU, and depth for lower layer is 5 meters. Since this is one way consolidation and this is a two way consolidation, that means the depth for upper layer will get half and the depth for downward layer will not get half. It will be 5 meter as 5 meter only. So now moving forward, let us solve this one. We know what is D square for first layer. Let us calculate it for upper layer. So what is the depth for upper layer? It is 2.5 square. So when you will calculate the T2 for upper layer, that is T2U, the T2 for upper layer will come out as 2.25 months. Now the time for lower layer, you just have to replace this 2.5 by 5. So it will come out to be 9 months. So after 2.25 months, the upper layer will completely consolidate. Since it has a two-way consolidation, definitely it will consolidate faster. You need not even calculate this time for upper layer, because you know by your intelligence level that upper layer will consolidate first, since it is allowing the drainage from two particular ways. But lower layer has drainage from only one way, so it will consolidate slower. So we have to calculate the time for lower layer. This will be the time in which the complete setup will consolidate. So the answer is that the layer will consolidate, this complete soil will get consolidated in 9 months. I guess this is given in option number C. So option number C is the correct option. Now moving on to the next question. The next question is related to the volume of compressibility. The question says that the following data are given for the laboratory. Sigma naught dash is given as 175 kilopascal. E naught dash is given as 1.1. Then there is an increase in stress, and the final stress is given as 300 kilopascal, and the final void ratio is given as 0.9. The thickness of the clay specimen is given. You need to calculate the coefficient of volume compressibility. That means you need to calculate MV. What is MV? MV is AV divided by 1 plus E naught. What is AV now? AV is delta E divided by delta sigma. and 1 plus E naught. You know what is delta E? Delta E will be, you are clearly given with 1.1 minus 0.9. This is delta E. What is delta sigma? The final stress is 300 and the initial stress is 175. So you can calculate the change in stress. It is 300 minus 175. And what is E naught? E naught is 1.1. So it is 1 plus 1.1. So this is 0.2 and this is 2.1 and this is 125. So when you will solve this, you will get it as 7.619 into 10 to the power minus 4, and units are meter square per kilonewton. So now the question has given that the coefficient of volume compressibility is dash multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4. So the answer will be only 7.619. You do not have to include this in your answer since it has already given as multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4 dash. So the answer will be 7.619. You can round it off. It is 7.62. Now moving on to the next question. And the next question is, the question says that the results of a consolidation test on an undisturbed soil sampled at a depth of 10 meter below the ground level are given as follow. Saturated unit weight is given as 16. Gamma saturated is given as 16 kilonewton per meter cube. And you are given with pre-consolidation pressure. It is given as 90 kilopascal. The water table was encountered at the ground level. Assuming the unit weight of water, gamma W is given as 10 kilonewton per meter cube. And the water table is at the ground level. And all the sample has been taken at a depth of 10 meters. So you will have to calculate the overburden pressure at 10 meters. So now the question is asking you, what is the over consolidation ratio? What is the OCR? You know what is OCR? OCR has the formula of pre-consolidation pressure divided by the effective stress, the normal effective stress, the overburden pressure we can say it as. So it will be 90 divided by sigma. So this is the ground level, suppose, and this is a 10 meter depth. The water table is encountered at ground level. You will have to calculate the effective stress. Remember, all these values are the effective stress values and not the total stress values. So what will be the effective stress at 10 meter below the ground level? It will be 16 gamma saturated. Let me write it completely. Gamma saturated multiplied by H minus gamma W multiplied by H. You will have to reduce this pore pressure so that you can get the effective stress. That is why I have reduced this pore water pressure. So what is gamma saturated? It is 16 multiplied by 10 and minus 10 multiplied by 10. So it will be 160 minus 100. It will be equal to 60. The effective stress at 10 meter depth will be equal to 60. So OCR will be 90 divided by 60. So it will come out to be 1.50. This is the required over consolidation pressure and it is given in option number B. So this is the required solution for this. Now moving on to the next question. The next question is based on the compression index. The void ratio, let me read out the question. The compression curve, the compression curve void ratio versus effective stress for a certain clay soil is a straight line in semi-logarithmic plot. What is semi-logarithmic plot? That means one side has the log values and another side has the straight or the normal values. And it passes through the points E equals to 1.2 and sigma V dash equals to 50. Let me write it down. E equals to 1.2 and sigma V dash equals to, sigma V dash means effective stress. This is 50 kilopascal and E equals to 0.6 and sigma V dash equals to 800 kilopascal. These are the points through which the curve passes through. Now you are asked to calculate simply the compression index. What is the value of compression index? You know what is compression index? Compression index is calculated by delta E divided by log 10 sigma naught plus delta sigma divided by sigma naught. This is log to the base 10. So what is delta E? Delta E is 1.2 minus 0.6 divided by log 10. This is in straight manner. This is in logarithmic form. That is why this is called as semi-logarithmic plot. Now log 10, sigma naught. What is sigma naught? Sigma naught is 50. And what is delta sigma? See, sigma naught plus delta sigma is the final stress value. And final stress value is directly given to you in the question. It is equal to 800. What is initial stress? Initial stress is 50. When you will solve this out, you will get the compression index as, remember this, it is always positive. It is never negative. So this is the value of CC. I guess it has asked you to round it off up to 2 decimal places. Never forget to round it off. So CC comes out to be 0.50. This is the required value of compression index. Moving on to the next question, the question says that a 3 meter thick clay layer is subjected to an initial uniform pore water pressure. The pore pressure is given as 145 kilopascal. The clay layer is sandwiched between two layers. One is of sand and another is the impermeable stratum. That means it is a one-way drainage. One-way path is given. The CV is given as 3 millimeter square per minute. 3 mm square per minute. And you are given with the time factor as 0.85. Now this is the time factor for 90% consolidation. You should remember the value of TV for 90% consolidation, since it may not be given in the question sometimes. The depth of the layer is 3 meters since it is one-way drainage. If it would have been a two-way drainage, we would have taken the depth as 1.5 meters instead of 3 meters. Now, it is asking you to calculate the time in days rounded off to the nearest integer required for 90% consolidation. The degree of consolidation is 90%, but this does not matter to you anymore since time factor is already given. This would only matter if the time factor has not been given to you. Now, you know the formula, TV equals to CVT upon D square. See, such questions are straightforward questions, but they can catch you some error. Give some error in your solution if you do not take care of the units. You will not get this question wrong anyhow if you take care of the units from the starting of your solution till the end of your solution. So now this is TV is given as 0.85 and the CV is given as 3. It is in millimeter square per minutes and multiplied by, let us calculate the T in minutes. And let us calculate the depth in millimeters so that the millimeter, this cancels out. This is millimeter square per minute. This is meter square. So when will we convert this D into meter, millimeter? So it will be millimeter square, and millimeter square will cancel in denominator and in numerator. So it is 3000 millimeter and the square of this. So T in minutes you will calculate 0.85 multiplied by 3000 square and divided by 3. So you can calculate it in minutes, but you can convert it into days since it is asking you in days. So multiply it by 60 and 24. So it will come out to be 1770.833 days. But it has asked you to round it off to the nearest integer. What is the nearest integer? 1770 or 1771? Since it is 0.8, so it is 1771 days. So this is the required number of days in which the consolidation up to 90% will get completed. Moving on to the next and the very important question. The question says that a water tank is to be constructed on the soil deposit. The combination of soil layers is given as a silty sand and a sand, and finally this lower one layer is the clay layer. Now the question says that a footing, circular footing of diameter 3 meter and depth of embankment is 1 meter. This is 1 meter. This is a circular footing that has to be placed at a depth of 1 meter, and the footing the vertical load that has to be taken up by the footing is 1500 kilonewton. The total load that the footing will take is 1500 kilonewton. So this will be the load that will be transferred when the footing will be constructed. So this is the additional load that will be taken up by the footing. So this will lead to the delta sigma. This will give us the delta sigma. Now unit weight of water is given as 10 kilonewton per meter cube, and the load dispersion is given trapezoidal, 2 vertical and 1 horizontal. द एक्सपेक्टेड सेटलमेंट ऑफ द टैंक हैज बीन आस्क्ड. व्हाट विल बी द एक्सपेक्टेड सेटलमेंट फॉर दिस यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट दैट हाउ मच विल द क्ले लेयर सेटल. ओनली कंसोलिडेशन ओनली टेक्स प्लेस इन क्ले लेयर. लेटर ऑन इन सैंड लेयर इन सिल्टी सैंड लेयर द कंसोलिडेशन विल टेक अप इमीडिएटली. But the primary consolidation will only take place in the clay layer. So the consolidation needs to be calculated for this clay layer and not for this sand layer and silty sand layer. So the footing will settle as much as the consolidation of this clay layer will occur. We know what is the settlement formula. Cc H0 divided by 1 plus E0 log 10 sigma0 plus delta sigma divided by sigma0. This is the formula for delta H. We know what is CC. CC is already given in the question. It is 0.3. We know what is H0. H0 is the height of the clay layer. This is the height which will take part in the consolidation process. Since this 10 meter only consolidates, this 6 meter and this 2 meter has immediate consolidation only. This has immediate compaction. The consolidation takes place only for the clay layer. So 10 meter will be the H0. What is E0? E0 is given in the question as 0.7. What is sigma0 and delta sigma? Now see, sigma0 is the actual overburden pressure that was initially there in the soil before the footing was placed. So before the footing was placed, what was the pressure? What was the stress level at this point? See, why I have drawn this dotted line in the middle of the clay layer? Since we always calculate the settlement in the clay layer, middle of the clay layer. The settlement here will be different, here will be different, here will be different. So to take the average of all these settlements, we calculate the settlement at the middle of the clay layer. So sigma naught will be the stress at this middle layer of the clay. So what will be the sigma naught? Sigma naught can be calculated by 15 multiplied by 2 plus this is 18. This is gamma saturated. The water level is at 2 meter below the ground level. So it is 18 multiplied by 6. The next is this is 5 meters and it has 18. I guess it has 18. Yes. 18 multiplied by 5. Now you have to subtract the pore water pressure. So pore water pressure will be 5 plus 6. That means 11 multiplied by 10. So this is how you calculate the actual overburden pressure or the initial overburden pressure at the middle of the clay layer. I hope you have understood that why we calculated it at the middle of the layer and not here and here. Since if you want to calculate the actual consolidation, then you will have to calculate it on different layers. 1 meter, every 0.2 meter, every 0.3 meter. So that will be a typical task as per the gate point of view. So we take a middle layer in the clay and calculate the consolidation at that middlemost layer. So when you will sort this out, you will get it as 118 kilonewton per meter square. Now the question comes that you have all these parameters known to you. You have also calculated sigma naught. What will be delta sigma? Delta sigma will be the effective stress that has increased due to the construction of the footing. You have been told that 1500 kilonewton is imposed on that circular footing. But now this is the load. You need to divide it by area to calculate the stress. Now what will be the area? The area will not be the area of this footing. The area will be the area at this level since the consolidation has to be calculated at this level. So you need to calculate the area at this particular level. This is 3 meters, you know. The diameter of the footing, you know, it is 3 meters. But you need to calculate this value and this value by the load dispersion. This distance, you know, you can calculate this distance from the bottom of the footing to this middle of the clay layer. How can you calculate this? This is 1, this is 6 and this is 5. So this will be equal to 12 meters. This distance will be 12 meters. So this will be half of this 12 since the degree of, you can calculate the dispersion degree and you can calculate, you know this distance, you can calculate this distance by the theta. So this will be 6 meters. Similarly, this will be 6 meters. So the total diameter at this point will be 6 plus 6 plus 3. So it will be 15 meters. 6 plus 6 is 12 and plus 3 is 15 meters. So the diameter at this particular middle of the layer will be 15 meters. Now you can calculate the area using this new diameter. This is the diameter that is dispersed diameter. So it is 1500 divided by pi by 4 multiplied by 15 multiplied by 15. So when you will solve this, you will get delta sigma as 8.4882 kilonewton per meter square. Now you know all the parameters, you just have to place these parameters. I am rubbing the diagram for now. You can calculate delta H as CC is known to be 0.3. It is 10, and let us convert it in millimeters since the question is asking you to calculate the settlement in millimeters. This is 1 plus 0.7. This is log 10. What is sigma naught? Sigma naught is 118 plus 8.4 divided by 118. So when you will solve this delta H, it will turn out to be 53.237 millimeters. This is the required settlement of the clay layer. I hope you guys understood this question. Practice many more questions like this. We will practice such questions also in the chapter related to foundations. So this is all about the consolidation. Thank you.